We're just off the coast north of Kaikoura, and we've been trying to map out where the fault ruptures happened on the seabed. And it was a really complex network of faults that broke to the surface on land, and the geologists have been crawling all over those to understand where they happened. And you can see behind us there, and there's a big hill running through there with a creamy white coloured face on it. One of those is a really big landslide that's come down and covered a farm, and another sort of small landslides within the bush. That's actually the larger fault scarp of the Papatia fault. This is really clearly expressed at the coastline and raised up the shore platform and the rocks there by several metres, up to 5 metres, I believe. You may be able to see one that actually crosses the beach there, and that's well over 2 metres high, right on the beach itself. And so we've been right up close into the beach to map out where those faults then extend from there out onto the seafloor offshore. So we're using a multi-beam echo sounder swath mapping system. And we've also got another pole over on the side of the boat where we have a seismic system. So this is a lower frequency than the multi-beam system, so the signal actually penetrates into the sediment. When we look right in here into this head part of the canyon, you can see this is the data that we collected in 2013. Everything's sort of very smooth and draped in mud. What we found when we collected the new data is that the earthquake has resulted in just a huge stripping event, and almost every part of this upper part of the slope has had the mud removed from it. So if we look at that again, very smooth slopes, a lot of mud just depositing onto that upper slope. The earthquake comes along, everything gets rattled to bits, and just all of the mud is gone from that upper part of the slope. This is a really complex earthquake. It'll give us a lot of information on what might potentially happen in other places, so we can understand our seismic hazard better. But it'll also help us to understand the stress changes in the Earth's crust resulting from this earthquake and how they might be transferred into other regions.